All right, so this was a Hellbox question that a lot of us, well, three of us asked, but considering only four filled out the Hellbox, that's a lot of us. And there was more information in the text, and there was more like subparts to this question, but this is really the heart of it. So it says the included angle of two sides of constant equal length S of an isosceles triangle is theta. Wow, that's a mouthful. Let's make a picture. So I know I've got some isosceles triangle. I know it said that. Let's go ahead and make sure it looks isosceles. Maybe looks isosceles, not equilateral, you know? So maybe something like this. Yeah, it looks pretty isosceles. Close enough. So it says the included angle, interrupter, of two sides of a constant equal length S of an isosceles triangle is theta. Okay, so that's a big interrupter. So the included angle, it says two sides of equal length S. So I've got S and S because it's an isosceles triangle. And the included angle to the angle in between is theta. Now it says if theta is increasing, so see, I'm if we're thinking about, you know, our acronym for related rates questions, because we know this is one. And I'll kind of indicate why I know that in a second. But we're in this already, you know, this AL part. We're analyzing and labeling. And so if I'm thinking about what it gives me there, it says if theta is increasing at a rate of 1/2 radians per minute. Ah, so 1/2 radians per minute. So what is this? When it's positive, because it says it's increasing. So it says increasing at a rate. This is a rate. This is a rate of change. This is a derivative. Well, so this is the derivative of what? Well, it's telling me how the angle is changing. Ah, so it's d theta. Well, with respect to what? Well, I can see right here, because they tell me it's based on time, right? So it's radians per minute. So units actually can kind of help us understand. It's a angle rate per minute, right? Or an angle rate per time. Okay, cool. So then it says, oh, it's starting to set up my goal. Find the rate of change of the area when theta equals pi over 3. Okay, so I'm looking at the rate of change of the area. How is the area changing? Derivative of the area. Got it. Rate of change of area is derivative of area. Derivative of the area with respect to most likely time, because they're saying, like, you know, that we're given a rate based on time. They're wanting to know how quickly it's changing. All right, so dt. And I want to know this when, notice I'm kind of setting it up this way, when theta equals pi over 3. And I really want to make sure that I know this, because this is the moment that I care about this, but I'm really caring about my derivative first, right? And it's like I'm watching my movie first. I'm watching things change, and then I want to focus on that moment in time as my movie's playing. Okay, so analyzed, yes. Labeled, check. Next step, relating equation. We need to find a relating equation. All right, so what do I need to relate? Area, right? Because I really want to relate these two things. Okay, so let's look over here. How would I find the area of that triangle? And if you think back to pre-calc, and they actually told you this in the book, but we knew that there was this area formula for triangles, like 1/2, and we came up with it, 1/2 AB sine of theta, where A and B were like two sides of a triangle, and theta was the angle in between them. So what that means for us is like theta is that angle in between, so we really could say 1/2 S times S times sine of theta. Or really, the area here is 1/2 S squared times sine of theta. Aha, there's my relating equation. I know that the area equals 1/2 S squared sine of theta. You see how it relates for us? It relates both theta and area. Ooh, but wait, I'm annoyed. I'm really annoyed. It's got an extra variable in there. But it doesn't. If you go back, keep in mind, right up in here, two sides of constant length, right? Two sides of constant length. So that means that S right there is really constant. It's not changing. So I can think about it like a number. It's a constant. That's just part of my coefficient. I don't have to worry about that. Awesome. So that means that I really could think about this if I really wanted to, right? If I really wanted to think about it this way, I could think about it as like 1/2 multiplied by, you know, 4 squared sine of theta, if that really helps me think about it, right? That's kind of what I'm doing here. Now, I don't really know that that's the side length, so I'm not going to leave that, but that's the way I could think about it if I wanted. All right. So I got my relating equation. Check. Yes. Awesome. All right. Get rid of some of that so we have some space here. Now what do I need to do? Well, keep in mind that D right there stands for take the derivative. Now we're starting to get down to brass tacks. That's the thing I wanted to. I just said down to brass tacks. So we want to take the derivative with respect to what, you know? Well, look, I'm looking for dA dt. I know d theta dt. So I'm really watching how the angle changes as time changes. I'm watching how the area changes as time changes. So I'm really going to come up and I'm going to say, how is this equation, how are both sides of this equation changing as time changes? And when I do this, right, I'm going to get dA dt equals 1/2. S squared is a constant, so that sticks around. It's a coefficient on the whole function, right? And then when I'm looking, sine of theta. Ooh, wait a second. Theta doesn't match up with time. So theta is changing as time changes, which means I'm dealing with like function and a function. I have sine of theta, and then theta is changing also. So theta is kind of like a covered up function. So outer cosine theta, and then times the derivative of the inner, d theta dt. Sweet. So I took my derivative. Now, let's flip to white because we're just about done. We want to evaluate. We'll come up here. I'm looking for this. This is a constant, so I'm good. This I know because that's the value in question. And this they gave me, so I know that too. So it looks like I have all the values I need. So I can go ahead and say dA dt equals 1/2 S squared, because that was a constant, that's a coefficient, right? Times cosine of, well, ooh, shoot. I wanted to do this when theta equals pi over 3, right? Okay, so cosine of pi over 3 multiplied by theta dt. Well, that's that 1/2. So I know dA dt when theta is pi over 3 is really going to be equal to 1/2 S squared. Well, cosine of pi over 3, that's 1/2 times 1/2. This is all really just 1/8 S squared. And now I've evaluated it. So now I just want to go ahead and put my answer back in context. I want to make sure I explain fully what my answer was. So I'm going to do this over here. It's always a good idea to answer their question with kind of like a restatement. So what did I find? Well, the rate of change of the area when theta is equal to pi over 3 is, you see, all I'm doing is I'm taking their question and I'm just restating it. I'm really saying, hey, this is what I found. You know, it's right there. Look. And then I'm just going to tell them my answer is 1/8 S squared. So I've told them what it is I found. So at this point, it seems like I'm done. And I actually am. If they gave me units for the lengths, I would definitely want to make sure that I included units here. I don't know, maybe it was like inches squared, right? Because S squared. And that was per minute, right? Because this is all dA/dt. So it'd be like, you know, it's units of area over units of time. They didn't give me units, so I don't need to talk about units here. Okay? So I hope this helps. Yeah, enjoy.